The popliteal fossa, it is a diamond-shaped space at the lower part of the back of the thigh and the upper part of the back of the leg. Boundaries upward and laterally formed by biceps femoris muscle, upward and medially formed by semitendinosus and semimembranosus, supplemented by gracilis sartorius and tendon of the adductor magnus. Lower lateral boundaries formed by lateral head of gastrocnemius and plantaris. Lower and medial boundaries formed by medial head of gastrocnemius muscle. This is diamond-shaped space forming the popliteal fossa. And this is the contents, two terminals of sciatic nerve, common peroneal and tibial nerves, then popliteal vein and popliteal artery. This is the floor of the fossa. The roof of the popliteal fossa is formed by skin and superficial fascia containing a small saphenous vein. Deep fascia, the floor, popliteal surface of the femur, back of the capsule of the knee joint, fascia covering the popliteus muscle. And the popliteus muscle takes origin intracapsular, arises from the anterior end of the groove on the lateral surface of the lateral femoral condyle and the lateral meniscus. Insertion in the posterior surface of the tibia just above the soleal line. Nerve supply from the tibial nerve. Action flex and rotates the leg medially. This action will unlock the knee joint at beginning of flexion. This is the popliteus muscle, takes origin intracapsular and inserted in the back of the tibia just above the soleal line. The contents of the popliteal fossa from deep to superficial, capsule of the knee joint, popliteal artery and its branches, popliteal vein and its tributaries, medial and lateral popliteal nerves, popliteal lymph nodes and fat, posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh. The popliteal artery starts at the opening in the adductor magnus as continuation of the femoral artery and passes downwards at the floor of the popliteal fossa. It ends at the lower border of the popliteus muscle by dividing into two terminals, anterior and posterior tibial arteries. The branches of the popliteal artery, number one, muscular branches to the surrounding muscles and the anastomose with fourth perforating artery. Then five genicular or articular arteries, two superior and inferior medial genicular, two superior and inferior lateral genicular and the middle genicular artery. In addition to two terminal branches, anterior and posterior arteries. This is the popliteal artery, comes from the opening or hiatus in the adductor magnus and ends at the lower border of the popliteus muscle. Anastomosis around the knee joint is formed by 10 arteries shared in this anastomosis. Descending branch of lateral circumflex come from profunda femoris artery. Descending genicular artery from the femoral artery in the adductor canal. Popliteal artery gives five genicular branches. Anterior and posterior tibial recurrent arteries from anterior tibial artery, then circumflex fibular from the posterior tibial, but sometimes arises from the anterior tibial. This is the anastomosis around the knee joint formed by 10 arteries. This is descending branch of lateral circumflex here, and this is genicular branches from the popliteal artery. Then popliteal vein starts at the lower border of the popliteus muscle by union between veni combatants of the anterior and posterior tibial arteries. First, it is medial to the popliteal artery, then ascends superficial to it at the middle of the popliteal fossa, then becomes posterolateral to the artery at the opening of the adductor magnus, where it continues as femoral vein. Tributaries of the popliteal vein, muscular veins from the surrounding muscles, genicular veins from the knee joint, then short saphenous vein after piercing the deep fascia in the middle of the popliteal fossa. The common peroneal nerve or lateral popliteal arises as one of two terminals of sciatic nerve. It enters the popliteal fossa at its upper angle and leaves the fossa at lateral angle. It passes around the neck of the fibula deep to peroneus longus and ends by dividing into two divisions, superficial and deep peroneal nerves. Branches cutaneous branches, chural communicating nerve joins the chural nerve at the back of the leg. Lateral cutaneous nerve of the calf supplies the anterior and the lateral surfaces of the leg. Articular or genicular branches, superior and inferior genicular, recurrent genicular ascends to the knee joint. Terminal branches, deep peroneal or anterior tibial and superficial peroneal or musculocutaneous nerve. This is the sciatic nerve. It gives the two terminals, the common peroneal, and this is the tibial nerve. Tibial nerve arises also as one of the two terminals of sciatic nerve. It enters the popliteal fossa at the upper angle and leaves it at the lower angle. It ends at the lower border of the popliteus muscle, where it enters the back of the leg to become the posterior tibial nerve. Branches from the main trunk. Cutaneous chural nerve arises in the middle of the popliteal fossa and descends with short saphenous vein to the lateral aspect of the foot to reach the little toe. Muscular branches are the following. Double nerves to gastrocnemius as branch to for each head. Nerve to plantaris muscle. Nerve to superficial surface of the soleus muscle. Nerve to popliteus, which descends downward, then curves around its lower border to supply the muscle from its deep surface. Then genicular branches, superior and inferior medial genicular and the middle genicular nerve.